Hello and welcome back. In our previous session, we saw the Python assignment, the basics of Python assignment. And now we will proceed with the basics of Python flow control. The normal flow of a computer program will be in an orderly fashion. At first, it will be executing line 1, then line 2, line 3, like that. But in some cases, we have to alter this flow of execution. We have to bypass, we have to move to the previous statement, we have to repeat or loop some statements, and for all these purposes we are using the flow control mechanism. And in this session we will be dealing with the most important flow control mechanisms. The first one is an if else conditional statement. Just like the name indicates, we are declaring a condition, an if condition. Here you can see we have a variable called value, which have a value of 99. And in this statement, we are checking if the variable value is having a value of 99. In that case, if this statement is true, which is actually true in our case, it will execute whatever the line you have after this if statement. Else if this value is having a number that is greater than 200, in that case it will execute whatever the statement or the set of statements you have in the else if part. And if none of these conditions are satisfied, in that case we will be including a default condition called the else condition. If any of these is not satisfied, the else part will be executing. It's very simple. An if part is there, then an else if part is there, then an else part is there. This else if part is also optional. If you want to include, you can include, or else you can leave this and use the else part. So let's try this in our Jupyter notebook. Let's declare the value, the variable name value equal to, just like in the example, 99. Then we are checking if value equal to, you can see here for assignment we are using a single equal to sign. Here for checking we are using two equal to sign, which means we are checking if the value is equal to something. Here if the value is equal to 99, then a colon and press enter. You can see the cursor is already having one indentation to the right. Whatever the statements we want to include within this if statement or if condition should be there within this indentation. In other programming languages, instead of this indentation, there will be a bracket like this, and within this bracket we have to write the code. But in case of Python, we have simple indentation. That's why Python is comparatively simple than other programming languages. Here we are printing, for example, if this is a speed value, we will be printing that it's fast. Now if you execute this, you can see it's printing it's fast. And now we will include an else if statement. Press a backspace and you will be back to the indentation matching the if statement. Here we are including L if value equal to 100, print that's too fast. We are checking if value is greater than or equal to 100. For example, if it's 200, then it should execute this statement. And then press backspace. We are including an else statement. If any of these conditions is not satisfied, else and a colon, then print it's safe, which means the speed is not greater than 100. For example, if it's 50, you can see it's printing that it's safe. So that's the if else statement.